Welcome to Enjoy Chemistry with Yash Private Limited. We are studying states of matter, liquid state. Our next property is viscosity. Viscosity is a measure of resistance to flow, which arises due to the internal friction between layers of a fluid as they slip past one another while liquid flows. Strong intermolecular forces between molecules hold them together and resist movement of layers past one another. When a liquid flows over a fixed surface, the layer of molecules in the immediate contact of surface is stationary. The velocity of upper layers increases as the distance of layers from the fixed layer increases. This type of flow, in which there is a regular gradation of velocity in passing from one layer to the next layer, is called laminar flow. If we choose any layer in the flowing liquid, the layer above it accelerates its flow and the layer below these retards its flow. You can see the middle layer has a velocity u. The upper layer has a velocity u plus du, and the lower layer has a velocity u minus du. This type of flow is called laminar flow. If the velocity of the layer at a distance dz is changed by a velocity value du, then velocity gradient is given by the amount du by dz. A force is required to maintain the flow of layers. This force is proportional to the area of contact of layers and velocity gradient. That is, F is directly proportional to A, where A is the area of contact, and F is proportional to du by dz, where du by dz is velocity gradient, the change in velocity with distance. So we can say F is directly proportional to A into du by dz. Now if we remove the proportionality term, we need to introduce the constant, and that constant is eta. F equals to eta A du by dz. Eta is proportionality constant and is called coefficient of viscosity. Viscosity coefficient is the force when velocity gradient is unity and the area of contact is also a unit area. Thus, eta is measure of viscosity. SI unit of viscosity coefficient is 1 Newton second per square meter, that is N(m⁻²). That is equals to Pascal second, Pa for Pascal, S for second. That is equals to 1 kg meter inverse second inverse. In CGS system, the unit of coefficient of viscosity is poise, named after great scientist Jean-Louis Poiseuille. 1 poise equals to 1 gram centimeter inverse second inverse, that is equal to 10⁻¹ kg meter inverse second inverse. Greater the viscosity, more will be the resistance to flow, so more slowly the liquid will flow. Hydrogen bonding and van der Waals forces may be just a London force of attraction, or even dipole-dipole interaction are strong enough to cause high viscosity. Glass is an extremely viscous liquid. It is so viscous that many of its properties resemble solids. This can be observed in very old houses with glass window panes. At the bottom of these glass window panes, you can find the thickness of glass is a little more than at the top. This indicates that glass is a supercooled liquid. which has a tendency of viscosity. Viscosity of liquids decreases as the temperature rises because at high temperature molecules have high kinetic energy and can overcome the intermolecular forces to slip past one another between the layers. So flow of molecule becomes easier as compared to lower temperature. So if flow is better, viscosity is poor. So at high temperature, viscosity decreases. The reciprocal of coefficient of viscosity of a liquid is called its fluidity, phi. So phi can be mathematically written as inverse of eta. Thank you. Keep learning and enjoy chemistry.